We're going on a picnic.
Going on a picnic, leaving right away. If it doesn't rain, we'll stay all day.
Did you bring the sandwiches?
Yes, I brought the sandwiches.
Did you bring the salad?
Yes, I brought the salad.
Ready for a picnic?
Here we go. Going on a picnic, leaving right away. If it doesn't rain, we'll stay all day.
Did you bring the melon?
Yes, I brought the melon.
Did you bring the apples?
Yes, I brought the apples.
Did you bring the lemonade?
Yes, I brought the lemonade.
Did you bring the cookies?
Yes, I brought the cookies.
Ready for a picnic?
Here we go. Going on a picnic, leaving right away. If it doesn't rain, we'll stay all day. Going on a picnic, leaving right away. If it doesn't rain, we'll stay all day.
I think the rain is stopping around here. We could actually probably go on a picnic. I wanted to show you the butterfly aviary. And you can see every one of our caterpillars changed into chrysalises. And every one of them emerged as butterflies. And I tried really hard to get a picture or a video of it coming out of a chrysalis, but they seemed to time it to absolutely the moment that I had to be out of the house. So that's what we had to, I just didn't get a picture. However, I also discovered, although nobody cares about the butterflies when they're caterpillars or chrysalises, but everybody wants to meet them, I mean my pets, when they are a butterfly. So I have had to put, let me tip this down so you can see this, clamps on the aviary so the cat doesn't accidentally release them and the dogs don't accidentally release them. So it's been a fun time. I always like put a heliotrope flower in there. They seem to really enjoy that. And sometimes they actually even lay eggs on it before they get released. And I have watermelon, juicy watermelon in there for them to go in and sip up. They also enjoy drinking the water from the soil around the plant as well. And I think that's because they can get minerals. It's kind of like them going in puddling out in the wild, where they all get together and they drink water out of a puddle. How great. Anyway, I was very excited about that. I am going to release them on Saturday. The wind is supposed to be down and the temperatures are supposed to be rising up. And I have invited my youngest grandson to come because we can't be in big groups yet. And we can be outside and enjoy a butterfly release together. And I will film that for you and put it on the Facebook page. Okay, let's write the date today. We have a few things left to do. Of course, I did not grab my eraser, so we'll get it. My reading tint. I have a whole bunch of those lanterns and they are way too much fun in a reading tint. All right, let's get our day started with the date. And today happens to be Friday. May 22nd, May 22nd of the year 2020, and the sound of the week, which we are sharing later, is ah. So here it is. May 22nd, the year 2020, and the sound of the week is ah. Okay, let's see. We have to finish our story. Who pooped in the park? It's right here. Yesterday, what footprints did we look at yesterday? I think we looked at badger prints. And now we are on to the last of the book. Michael followed the tracks backwards from the hole and spotted some big footprints. I found deer prints over here. Those aren't deer prints, Dad pointed out. They're not as pointy and they don't turn in at the tips. Right, said Mom. They don't show dew claw marks. They're mountain goat tracks. So, here is the deer track, the buck, and here's a mountain goat track. Look at how different they are. And this is mountain goat's gap. It kind of almost looks like deer, but do you see the difference? It appears to be kind of pointy. They almost look like little acorns. Mountain goats usually spend the summer up in high mountains, said Dad, but they come down here too. Whoa, Dad, what happened to this tree? Did an animal do that? Something was sharpening its claws, Michael, and if you look how high those scratch marks go, it was pretty big. It's not just the animal that's big, said Emily. Look at the size of its poop. Oh, looks like we found your grizzly bear, said Dad. Let's see what we can learn today. What can you figure out about this bear? He's taller than you, and he has really long claws, said Michael. And he's eating plants, said Emily, because there's no hair or bones in here. Good, said Mom. What else? Okay, here's the little straight poop box. It says, grizzlies eat almost anything. They like fish and many kinds of plants, roots and berries. Grizzlies can hunt their own meat, but they often steal kills away from wolves and other predators. They even eat moths and insects. And look at the size of that scat. I think you would notice that if you saw it on a trail. Let's see. Here's his footprint, said Michael. It's huge. He has more toes than a coyote, and his claws are longer than my fingers. I told you you would be able to count a grizzly's toes, laughed Dad. He rubbed off some hair on the tree, said Emily. It's really dark, but the tips are gray. Just like Dad, sup my old mom. Don't pick on me, grinned Dad back. All right, the straight poop on this. Hair with gray tips on it is called grizzled. And it's the grizzled hair that gave the grizzly bear its name. So I didn't know my hair was grizzled. Look at those huge prints. And it's kind of interesting that I think that must be their front paws, and this one must be their back paw. Oh, and if you are around trees and there is mammals around and they're running through the underbrush, you can often find little bits of hair that has been caught in the sticks, and you can look at it and see what it looks like up close. You might be able to find deer hair or coyote hair around here. Let's see. As they ate dinner that night, everyone talked about how much fun they had. "We didn't see very many animals," said Emily, "but it seemed like we did." "And I didn't get scared once," said Michael. All right, in the back of this book has some great notes. It talks about, and it gives you a diagram of the animals, what their tracks look like, and what their scat looks like. And they actually have books out there that is dedicated to identifying scats and tracks. I have identification for books for birds. I have identification books for flowers and trees and fish and butterflies. So they actually have scats and tracks identification books. And that would be an interesting book to find in a library when they open back up. Oh, what else do we have going today? We have a scavenger hunt. It's a nature one outside. Take pictures, if you can, of the things you find. You might want to, when you're all done, draw a picture of your best thing. You can send it in an email to me, or you can post it on the Sagebrush Montessori Facebook page. That would be wonderful. There are files in our OneDrive that the pictures can be put into. So our sharing time today is at 10 o'clock in a Zoom meeting. The link is in the posts that where you find your letters of suggestions every day. I hope to see you there. I hope you found some awesome things to share, and you're on it looking for things. And I also hope that you have an awesome weekend. Remember, it is a 3-day weekend, so I will be sending my next suggestions on Tuesday. Enjoy your time.